Sends it in the air toward Lynn Bowden. And that's out of the back of the end zone. Down on the field, Holly Rowe. An excellent offensive line for Kentucky. They fake it to Snell, and as a result, a wide open receiver, C.J. Conrad, one of the best tight ends in the country, a 17-yard gain to the 42.
This is an R.
He's here tonight. He's been a great influence on his son. Wilson faked the toss and managed to get away from the first tackler, but not Tyrell Dodson. He escaped to the season, relying on that running game. Wilson got it off quickly. Snell's in trouble and dumped for a loss. Otaro Alaka, their leading tackler for the year, drops Snell at the 44-yard line. This in Lexington to learn the rules of American football. Good punt and a fair catch made at the 13-yard line by Numbers. Off to a solid start. And Travion Williams dumped behind the line of scrimmage. Mike Edwards, one of eight seniors who starred on this Kentucky defense, up from his safety spot.
One, two, you better watch out for, 41.
He was blocked well, and Mond into traffic with a nice throw to Jay Sternberger, the junior college transfer with a 14-yard. And number 41, the biggest concern for the A&M offensive line, high throw over the head of Jay Sternberger. And incomplete, and Texas A&M will punt. The year there would be the single season FBS record. And what a punt this is. David Bouvier let it go, and the Aggies down it at the 6-yard line. 3 pounds, already third in career rushing at Kentucky. Has room on the corner. And out of bounds at the 18 with a first down, chased out by Charles Oliver. Long count by Wilson. In a crowd, got hit just as he delivered, and it's a bit too high for Lynn Bowden. They cover punts very well.
Wow.
Rashad Paul scooped it up and just took it out of bounds. 10 minutes played. Texas A&M on offense for the second time, and Travion Williams dumped by the safety, Mike Edwards. They have him up around the line of scrimmage to deal with the terrific running back Williams.
He really wasn't right on the line of scrimmage, so the two linemen pulling didn't see him. They went right by him. He got into the backfield for a loss of yardage play.
Third down and 11. Conservative play call by Jimbo Fisher. Will it result in the first down? Travion Williams stood up. Forward progress stopped about a yard shy of the line to make. Braden Mann, these punters showing off their first efforts. That's a low kick that he got away with. Stayed inbounds and bounced for about 15 yards along the sideline. Mack is 6'1", 320. They flip it to Lynn Bowden with some running room. He can fly inside the 20, inside the 10, and into the end zone. Touchdown, Kentucky. 54 yards.
Watch number six. It looks like he almost doesn't know that Bowden has the football. He runs right by him. Olaka takes a bad angle, and Lynn Bowden with an outstanding play. We talked.
A nice job blocking him. He got in the face of Mond and almost batted it out of his hand. And Mond down back at the 18-yard line. I want to see who it is. Of course, Coach Stoops back on his own defense. Jay Sean Corbin with some running room. Bounced off the head of Mike Edwards, got a few more, and came up 2 yards short of the line to make it the 33, a 15-yard pickup. Looking free. Travion Williams has 16 yards rushing. It's Mond doing the work with his feet. And that was the issue for him, Todd. He was recruited by Kevin Sumlin as a dual threat running and throwing quarterback, and he wondered how much the running part would be of flipping quarterbacks and sending them on to the NFL. He was very excited. He thinks he's a much better pocket passer than he was, and perhaps the improvement on display there as he dodged the rush and got it to Courtney Davis for a first down to the Kentucky 36. Mitchell nearby, they snap it. They hand it off to Jay Sean Corbin, and it doesn't look like he got it.
You know, the last fourth and short, they were under the center and ran quarterback sneak. This time they put the quarterback in the shotgun and handed it to Corbin, and I'm not sure he got it.
Interesting, no Travion Williams on the field.
You're already 5 yards off the ball, and they didn't get a good push up front. It's just a matter if he got that ball across the line.
That tackle, they are much deeper in the defensive line than they've been in the past. Another of the many factors in their success, and they're short by almost a yard. Kentucky takes over on downs. Kentucky leading 7-0. And the toss dropped by Snell, and he scoops it back in. Looked like Kingsley Keke had a great chance to get it for Texas A&M.
This is a bad pitch. This pitch is high and up on the shoulder pad of Benny Snell. You want that ball low and right in front of him so he can catch it and turn up field. They use this action a lot. They can toss it, the quarterback can keep it. They'll also throw off of it, but that was a bad pitch.
It's per game passing. He's poised in the pocket. He can run. He got 105 rushing yards in their win at Florida. He got rocked well short of the first down. Belt Paul back deep. Driving spiral and a fair catch made at the 15-yard line. Under duress, Mond steps up but does not get back to the line of scrimmage. It's the true freshman, Chris Oates, filling in for Cash Daniel. Braden Mann, another bomb. Bouvier watches it sail over his head and into the end zone. 121 yards of offense, 54 on the touchdown play. Terry Wilson in a crowd. Didn't look like he could follow through as he tried to get it to Dorian Baker. In A&M history, and the longest since 1944 when Bobby Goff set a school record with an 86-yard kick against Texas Tech. Offense has changed so much over the years, and Jimbo's offense, yeah, we're familiar, but it really isn't much of a factor in this game.
Reason why they're undefeated.
Travion Williams lost a yard. He's rushed for just 20 yards, less than 3 per carry. Here he is as a receiver. Lots of running room down the sideline and into Wildcat territory out at the 39. Early second round pick, number 35 overall. Good throw, Mon, first down, first and goal. Jay Sternberger on the receiving end. Curve option, perhaps, nope. Straight pass to the end zone, caught.
Yes.
Touchdown, Courtney Davis. Blew a 21-point lead in the fourth quarter, then won on the last second field goal. Terry Wilson is ripped down by Dalen Mack. One of Holly Rowe's favorite players in the country at 6'1", and that's probably generous. Just 119 yards of offense for the Cats. Wilson started to run, then threw it wide to Lynn Bowden. He's down at the 20, and they come after Duffy. He knew they were coming. He still got off a beauty. And a fair catch made at the 30-yard line with 26 seconds to go.
So, he's going to run it.
Travion Williams, a little stat padding late in the half. Out of bounds, but out of time. And there is a flag down back at...
Thank you.
It is indeed. Kellen Mond handed it off to Travion Williams, and he's free. And a big tackle by the safety, Darius Wester. He might have been off to the races. It's a 19 because of a targeting ejection. Second half of last week's game against South Carolina. Mond is smothered by Jamar Watson. And now there are whistles. For a moment, there weren't any. Take the lead for the first time tonight. Whoa, trouble with the snap. Mond had to get on it, and a big loss back to the 30 with Mike Edwards approaching quickly. Snapped it with two. Mond takes the short throw. Jay Sternberger and a good tackle by Lonnie Johnson for a short gain. They're way short of the first down. True freshman from Katy, Texas, near Houston. That one, Houston has a problem. Off the upright and no good. Wilson running away from Matabike, running toward the marker and doesn't get there. Donovan Wilson, the veteran safety, closed fast, and it'll be a punt for Kentucky on fourth down. These are wind aided. There's not a lot of wind in the stadium. It's kind of a crosswind. They're just bombing it in each direction. Rashad Paul. Nifty return, weaving through a lot of traffic, and they finally got him down at the 27-yard line. 11. Coach at Monmouth was very upset when he told him he wasn't going to take the scholarship offer. You can understand why. Mon held in there and got it off to Jay Sternberger. Does some nice work after the catch. And a big gain for Texas A&M, 18 yards. They're 5 yards shy of midfield. And plenty of running room for Jay Sean Corbin. Chopped down by Jordan Griffin at the Kentucky 39-yard line. And a problem on the handoff, and Mon got it back. Jordan Jones had a shot at it. He was near Mond again.
This is obviously a read play for Mond. He puts it in the belly, and then just the back has to assume he's getting the ball. So he'll clamp down on it to take the football.
Seven passes. They started out 1 for 6 on third down, 5 for 6 since. He got hit as he threw, and it was a flutter ball. Jamar Watson with the good rush.
Oh, beautiful.
Third down and 9. Look out, Terry Wilson. Sidesteps the rush of Matabike. Now has a chance for a first down, but he's tripped up. Another open field stop by Donovan Wilson. Back at his 24-yard line for A&M.
Jeez.
These return men might want to back up. That drove him back about 13 yards to make the catch. And he brought it back to the 21. 57-yard punt. 50 in a 7-7 game. Second and 10, A&M. Kellen Mond on target. Travion Williams, not much of a receiver prior to tonight. He had 45 career catches in 3 years. As a result of this style, it's been a much more rested defense than in years gone by. Nice play by Mike Edwards. Allen quick off the ball, but it's a quick throw, and there's a big mistake. Interception by Darius West. First turnover of the night by either team, and West brought it back to the 49-yard line.
Much. It's a hard throw by Kellen Mond, and it surprises the receiver. He's not ready to catch the football. It goes off his hands, and when a ball goes up in the air like that, normally something bad happens. The first turnover, and Kentucky makes a big play.
Kentucky, but they're all about just continuing to win. Can they make a play now? Wilson, Snell didn't even see it coming. And it's an incomplete pass with Otaro Alaka moving in to cover Snell and wallop him, perhaps, if he made the catch. Max Duffy, another good punt, well away from the return man. It drove Rashad Paul well to his right, but he has lots of running room. And he's out to midfield. Out of bounds at the 49. That's how anemic the Wildcats offense has been tonight. Mond off the hands of one receiver and into the paws of Jay Sternberger. Touchdown, Texas A&M. For 82 yards passing and a touchdown. A lot of that was after the catch by Bowden. He cannot escape. Here comes a blitz off the corner. It's a screen to the other side to Snell with blockers. And he's down 4 yards short of the first down.
See, that's
a go as Max Duffy sends a hook skyward. And Rashad Paul, the fair catch at the 24. A&M leading.
Wow, almost fumbled that snap.
Yeah, he's in trouble. Mond lost the football. It got batted away.
Oh my
Kentucky
gosh.
Has it. It's Darius West. And the undefeated season is still alive and thriving in the Commonwealth. They're an extra point away from a tie.
I can't stress enough how different it is taking snaps under center when you've never done it. Watch the bobbled snap first. That blows up the timing of the play. He doesn't get the fake, and then he doesn't secure the football at the end of the play. And Kentucky's defense, which has played valiantly tonight, not only gets their second turnover, but turns it into points that the offense has not been able to manufacture.
4.6 tonight. He averages 6 coming in. Here's pressure on Mond, who tries to throw it away with Jordan Jones on him.
He was not out of the tackle box.
And the flag is down.
He was not.
Guard line. Travion Williams.
Got some room for the punter. That's a good safe call. Kentucky was in a prevent defense.
Man leading the nation in punting. Wow. David Bouvier in trouble inside the 10. And it's the 12th man, fan favorite, Colin Gillespie. Down at 11. 25 seconds to go. Undefeated Kentucky having a magical year till now. Wilson running out of time. He lost the football. Otaro Alaka knocked him down. The ball came out. Benny Snell got it back. There's a flag on the play. He's about 25 yards off the line of scrimmage. Not a great putt by Duffy. No. And now A&M, if they could make one play, they might be able to try a long field goal.
Or even tip it.
And here comes pressure. Looked like Allen got held for a moment. No flag on the field. Up and goes into the end zone. And it's incomplete.
That got knocked down. The ball's on the ground.
And they're in the pistol. And a lot of time wasted. And Wilson's down. They might have got a little too tricky for themselves. And Kingsley Keke with a huge play back at the 25-yard line.
They thought they were going to fool the A&M defense. They had two tight ends. They're going to release them both out on the route. A&M was not fooled at all. They played pass beautifully. They had both receivers covered. And then Terry Wilson not able to get away from Keke. The timeout caused Kentucky to change the play. And now they have a long field goal attempt.
Here, former walk-on to give them the lead in overtime. Bang! Off the crossbar and short. Right down the middle, but he clanked it off the crossbar.
And you think of the 5 yards lost by Terry Wilson on that sack. Third down, depending on what they do here.
Kick it on third down. It might not matter. It does not. Travion Williams wins the